Form, the eternal sound, his speech. The moon and stars are his ornaments. To that embodiment of auspiciousness, I bow. Dance in India is a celebration of the body, the mind, and the spirit. And in its evolution, it is universal and timeless. Dance is darshan, a philosophy, a path, to attain the seen and the unseen, the tangible and the intangible. It is artistic yoga which reveals the spiritual through the corporeal and aims to transcend the boundaries of time and space. The artist and the art are inseparable. The dance is a ritual for the dancer entering the sacred space. From the moment she commences her temporal embellishments towards the spatial. Nataraja is a lord of dance, the embodiment of the eternal cycle of life. Damaru, the kettle drum in his right hand, is the origin of the primordial sound Om. The burning fire in his left palm is the symbol of decimation. As Pashupati, he holds the deer in his hand, protector of all that is animate. The crescent moon and the river Ganga adorn his flying tresses. He reigns over the Panchabhuta, the five elements of ether, air, water, fire, and earth. Nataraja's dance represents the Panchakritya, the five acts in the cosmic cycle. Creation, preservation, dissolution, illusion, revelation, and grace. Nataraja is the latent masculine radiance. Shakti is a divine feminine creative energy. Shiva and Shakti fuse into completeness.
Kukuta, takundari kitataka, tadiki didigi ding ding gugutari taka ding guta, kurdagata talangutaka ding ding gugutta, ding gugutta, kukuta, takundari kitataka, tadiki didigi ding ding gugutari taka ding guta, kurdagata talangutaka, tadiki didigi ding ding gugutari taka ding guta, kurdagata talangutaka, tadiki didigi ding gugutari taka ding guta, kurdagata talangutaka ding ding gugutta, ding gugutta, Kukuta, Takuntari Ketataka. Ardharareeswara, where Shiva and Shakti, where Purusha and Prakriti, where Yin and the Yang, the male and female energies fuse together, merge together to become
one complete whole. This merging we see around us, and it is there within us.
The temple is the sacred space wherein the gods reside. It was also the cultural space where art and dance flourished. The temple is a metaphor for the human body, wherein resides the soul. The Omnipotent is deified in the temple's sanctum sanctorum, the Garbhagriha. The creation of the stream of knowledge on dance, the Natya Veda, has a mythological dimension. The lesser beings approached Brahma, the creator, and spoke of a world plunged in pain, sorrow, and anarchy, devoid of human values. They asked him to create a plaything, a krida niyata, that could entertain while imparting a sense of values. Brahma culled from the ancient Vedas the first four streams of knowledge, recitation from Rig Veda, music and song from Samaveda, histrionics from Yajurveda, and sentiments from Atharvaveda. Thus, he created the fifth Veda, the Natya Veda. Then, Brahma taught the Natya Veda to sage Bharata, who made a precis of it and handed down the earliest treatise of dramaturgy, the Natya Shastra. The churning of the mighty ocean is described in the first act of the Natya Shastra. It is an allegorical tale symbolizing the churning of humankind from regression to progression by awakening the coiled, latent energy of positivity. Orchestrated by the gods themselves, the demigods and the demons churn the mighty ocean with a giant serpent, Vasuki, as the rope. Dark poison spills and chokes the environment. Lord Shiva drinks the poison to wipe out the smothering negativity. And the waters are clean once again. The devas and the asuras churn on and on. They churn and churn. From the cleansed ocean emerges the tree of life. As they churn on, the divine cow, Kamadhenu, the giver of all things good, rises out of the milky ocean. Finally, from the depths of the vast ocean emerges the pot of nectar. the Amrita Kalasham, the symbol of immortality.
Centuries ago, the great Tamil saint Tirumular has said of Indian art that it makes men of beasts and gods of men.
Mythology abounds in stories of the victory of good over evil. Epics like the Ramayana and the Mahabharata are popular themes in Indian dance. Myths are not just stories. Physical phenomena are given a metaphysical representation. They thus remain evergreen and relevant. Classical dance embraces an ocean of traditional literature, rich in poetic imagery. India has a unique tradition of transmitting knowledge through the Guru Shishya Parampara. The Guru leads his disciple from darkness to light. He belongs to a rich tradition and his entire family is steeped in the art form. Eminent Natyacharyas and Natuvanars were the custodians of our classical dances.
I would like to say we are very fortunate to be born in this same parampara, which is known for its loyalty, devotion, integrity and purity. According to me, we remember at least 8 generations. My father Kuppaya Natuvanar, his father Panchapakesa Natuvanar, who is the co-author of Abhinaya Navaneetam, The first book in Tamil to deal with this Abhinaya aspect of this dance technique, which is based on Abhinaya Darpanam, known as Abhinaya Navaneetam, which was published around 1886. So after my father, my brother, Guru Mahalingam Pillai, my brother-in-law, Guru Govindaraj Pillai, my sister, Srimadi Karunambal, my another guru who was in Calcutta, Guru Maradappa Pillai, and of course myself, we're all trained by all these gurus, the village called Tiruvade Marudu. That is the Madhyarjuna Kshetra, where even Adi Shankara went and bowed down before Mahalinga Swami and asked for his approval for this Advaita Siddhantam.
From across the continents, foreigners came to India in search of the elusive inner peace and happiness. Iliana Chitaristi was one such seeker.
Orient Express up to Istanbul, then by a private bus up to Kabul, then by a public bus up to Peshawar, and from Peshawar to Amritsar by train. So it took 1 month. Somebody had given me a piece of paper, a name which for me was very difficult to even pronounce, forget to remember. Lucharan Mohapatra. Went directly to the bus stand in Bhubaneswar, show it to a rickshaw bala. I said, do you know where this gentleman lives? And he straight brought me in Cuttack. From Bhubaneswar, he went by bus to Cuttack. And he straight brought me to Guruji's house. As I was, with all my curling hair open, one sleeveless banyan and one rainbow skirt. Because I still was in hippie rebellion state. And so he was so magnanimous to accept me, although his wife was quite terrified by my aspect. And so I told him that I was going to stay for 6 months. So what happened is that slowly, without me realizing it, those 6 months became 6 years without ever going back to Italy. It was all correlated with what I was learning in dance. So the pujari who was coming in the morning and in the evening to do arati was singing the same song which we were learning. When Guruma was making chapati, she was just sitting like this. And this is exactly the same position that Guruji has for composing Kuruya Dunandana, no? Kuruya Dunandana Chandana. It was a continuation of life and art, art life. So something which I would not have found in any other place.
जो जिसके अंदर प्राण है, जीव है, वो सभी मुझे लगा बगैर रिदम की कुछ भी नहीं है. हर पेड़ का झूमना वो ऐसा लगता, कई बार कहता कंपोज करता हूँ मैं तो ऐसा लगता है जैसे पेड़ के डाले हैं और उसके अंदर बॉडी जो है उसका तना जो है वो झूमता है. कभी लगता पत्तियाँ खलकती हैं टाइम पे, जैसे ड्रॉप ऑफ द वाटर पड़ता है ना, थक थी था तो ये काम करने लगा. ऐसा लगता ड्रॉप पड़ रहा है. फ्लावर्स भी डांस करते हैं बिकॉज द एयर भी डांस करती है. ओशन इतने सालों से ऑलवेज दिस कमिंग लहर, लहर जो है वो राउंड लेता हुआ आता है एंड एकदम शोर के पास जाके फिर वापस रिवर्स होता है. आरोही अवरोही जिस सारे गाँव पता नहीं था सारी धर्म वगैरह था, इज ऑलवेज इन द नेचर. एंड ऑल द ग्रह जो आकाश में हैं, शुक्र ग्रह, मंगल ग्रह, फला, ये सब डांस कर रहे हैं. पृथ्वी नाचती है, सब कुछ नाचता. नाच बहुत छोटा शब्द है मगर वो पूरी जिंदगी है.
Living in the lap of nature, did man first dance at the sight of rain, frolicking in rhythm with the falling raindrops?
Get it out.
Did the hunter break into a triumphant dance to celebrate his prowess? Dance then emerges mankind's obeisance to nature in search of a new dawn. Ago, in Mohenjo-daro of the Indus Valley civilization, was this dancing girl. Look at her confident posture, her legs slightly forward, beating to time, beating with time, beyond time, to 5,000 years later. In ancient India, dance flourished through the institution of the Devadasis, the dancers dedicated to the temple. They danced, performed rituals, and presided over auspicious events. The Devadasis, the practitioners, received the dance in its entirety from the Natyacharyas and the Natuvanas, who were the custodians and the teachers of the art. With the passage of time, the royalty of medieval India was awakened to the depth and splendor of the multidimensional Indian classical dance. The aesthetics of classical dance was all-encompassing, drawing its essence from poetry and painting, music and sculpture, form and content. The river of dance flowed on, even as it was impacted by its socio-political challenges. Classical dance readapted itself to its changing environment as it relocated to the royal courts of the Mughals and the Nawabs of northern India, even as it continued to flourish in the temples and spiritual spaces of southern and eastern India. From then to now, classical dance and sculpture have had a symbiotic relationship, drawing inspiration from one another. In the mid-20th century, the freedom movement against British rule was determined by the need for a national Indian identity. The role of Natyacharyas in preserving classical dance and the birth of dance institutions represented this resurgence. Kala Kshetra in Chennai was established by the great visionary Rukmini Devi Arundel to redefine and nurture Bharatanatyam in defiance of the social stigma that came to be attached to the dance. Kala Mandalam in Kerala that gave a second life to three major classical performing arts of Kerala. Kathakali, Koodiyattam and Mohiniyattam. Darpana Academy in Ahmedabad, presided over by the stately matriarch Mrinalini Sarabhai, who took the dance to and popularized it in Western India.
I think when Darpana was started in 1949, nobody north of Chennai and Andhra knew very much about the southern classical styles of dance. So when she married and came to Gujarat, she had to educate half a continent. So she, in the initial stages, stuck very much to her classicism, changing the language very often so that she could break certain mental barriers that people had in dismissing anything south of the Vindhyas as, ye to Madrasi hai, we don't understand this. But she kept very much the classical Bharatanatyam and Kathakali. My vision over the last 20 years has been really for Darpana to be a crucible for inventive and innovative arts. But coming from a standpoint of very, very strict training before you can throw the training away.
Today, Indian classical dance is an integral part of the Indian aesthetic and identity.
Natya is the essence, quintessence of the imitation of the three worlds. And it says, Trailokya Sayasaya Sarvasya Natya Bhavanu Kirtanam. So everything that is in the three worlds is contained in Natya.
This eight classical dance forms for me is a meditation. All the classical dance forms follow some grammar, and not only the technical side, but there is a great philosophy.
People in the coming generations, this quality has always to be maintained, that they have to break from their this, you know, speed and this wanting to get things there and then and done and fast. Constantly be reminded of something, you know, very organic.
Being a girl from this generation, I have become spiritual because of Satriya. It has given me a meaning to life.
Bharatanatyam ulla vaangi adu purinji rasa ibdi veliye kondu varano abindrathu kandipa theva ena andu oru alagu adu enna adu Bharatanatyam illa irukku.
I wish to dance my life every day. It's a way of finding myself.
Here, the guru, teacher, teaches the shishyas, disciples, the grammar of classical dance.
Vane vastu nishedhane
patak. Hand gestures, hasta mudras and their usages, viniyogas.
Patak bhaktari mukah dahasta pushpaputah utsanga.
Movements of the neck, griva.
Tirashchina tathaiva.
Movement of the eyes, drishtibheda.
Alokitam sachi pralokita nimilite.
Movement of the feet, pada sanchalana. And varied gaits, charis drawn from nature and the environment.
All classical dance forms in India have three major aspects: nrita, nritya, and natya. Nrita is sheer, pure rhythmic dance. The dancer uses movements of the body to energize the space of performance.
Gamma, sanida, ni, sa, gamma, ga. Gamma, sanida, ni, sa, gamma, ga. Sa, gamma, da, ni, da, ma, ga. Gamma, da, ni, sa, ni, da, ma. Ni, sa, da, ni, ma, da. A, gamma, da, ni, sa, ni, da, ni, da, ma, ga, ma, ma, ga, di, sa, gamma.
In Nritya, the added dimension of expression enriches the dance.
ಬಿನಾಯಕ ಬೃಂದಂ ಶ್ರೀಮಂಗ್ರಿ ಕಮಲಂ ನಾ ಮುಕಿ ನಮತಂ ಗೋವಿಂದ ಮುಕುಂದ ಪದ ಬಿನಾಯಕ ಬೃಂದಂ ತಾಪಿತ ಬೇಪಿತ ಬ್ರಜ ನಿತಿ ತ್ರಾನಂ ತಾ ಖೇರ್
ದೋ ದೋಸ್ತ್ ಹೈ ದ ಲೇಜಿ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ದೋ ಒಂದ್ ದೋಸ್ತ್ ಬೋಲಾ ಐಸೆ ಐಸೆ ಇತ್ತಾ ಕ ದಿ ಗ ತಾ ಥೂ ಗ ದಿ ಗ ತಾ ಕ ತಾ ದಿ ಕ ದ ದ ಗಿ ನ ಥೈ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ तक दिख तथुक दिख तक तधिक दधगिन थे तक दिग ताथुंग दिग तक तधिक दधगिन अरे तक दिख तथुक दिख तक तधिक दधगिन थे तो चलो घोड़े पे चलेंगे तक दिग ताथुंग दिग तक तधिक दधगिन थे तो पकड़ता कि तक दिख तथुक दिख तक तधिक दधगिन थे पकड़ के ले जाता
is dance drama with different dancers enacting various characters. Abhinaya is from the root ni naya, which means to lead. With the prefix abhi, abhinaya means that which leads towards, that which suggests.
Swamirara, yaduvam sasuda buddhi kandra,
Radha is waiting for Krishna and Krishna could not come the whole night. Aisa jaage ho kahin rehna re ha, kahin raat mein jaage ho, jaage ho kahin rehna re ha, jaage ho kahin rehna re ha, jaage ho kahin रैन रे हाँ जागे हो कहीं रैन रे हाँ जागे हो कहीं जागे हो कहीं रे आलसाने नैना रतना रे चाल लटपटी आए हो होत भोर जागे हो कहीं रे मलिन गात नख लागे हैं कपोलन पे बॉडी एकदम ऐसा है मलिन गात नख लागे हैं कपोलन पे दसन दाग छिपाए बिंद कहे ना मानू लाख कहीं कर जोरी जागे हो कहीं रैन जागे हो कहीं रैन जागे हो कहीं रैन जब रस की अनुभूति हम करते हैं उसका रिएक्शन होता है ऑडियंस को जो देखते हैं ना हम अगर करुणा कर रहे हैं उससे ऑडियंस के ऊपर जो उसका असर पड़ता है वही रस का वो एक रूप बन जाता है
द नाइन बेसिक इमोशंस इन द नाट्य शास्त्र द नव रसास लव श्रृंगार रस valor, veera rasa. Compassion, karunya rasa. అద్భుత రస లాఫ్టర్ హాస్య రస ఫియర్ భయానక రస Revulsion, bhivats rasa, anger, raudra rasa, Shanta.
The experience of rasa culminates in ananda. Ananda, which is sublime bliss, a state which is egoless and cosmic.
Ananda danam 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 dum danam dum danam dum danam dum danam 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 nam dum da danam da danam da danam da nam dum da nam dum da danam da danam da danam da nam dum da danam da danam da danam da anam da danam da danam da danam da nam dum da danam da danam da danam da